To adopt a child is really to show unconditional love and knowing that when I adopt this child, I'm making that child a full member of my family and I'm going to love that child unconditionally.
One of the reasons why we came to Shanghai is to explore the need for orphan care. And you know, one of the big things I've seen over these last 15 years is that there has been a shift among myself, among my workers, and among the Chinese.
My name is Aaron. I'm the assistant director here at the Shanghai Healing Home. My wife and I came here about 6 years ago to help out with the home. We had come to China 8 years ago to work at a medical school, so my wife and I are both nurses. Our first year here, we had heard about the home, and we wanted to come and volunteer for a little bit. Came and volunteered, and after that first day, I was talking to one of the founders, and I said, listen, if you need medical help, anything like that, just let me know. Next day, she got on the phone. She said, you know, come here now. We need some more help with medical stuff. So I started working, you know, maybe just volunteering once a week, then it was twice a week, then three times a week. And soon it became, I had two full-time jobs. And at that point, I had to make the decision, were we going to leave the medical school and come here full-time? And obviously that's the way the Lord was leading us. So the home was started back in 2009 by an American family and a Chinese lady. The mission was to care for children with medical conditions. And not only to care for the medical conditions, we really want to care for the whole child. That's the physical, that's the mental, that's the emotional, and even the spiritual. That's our main goal here at the home. So we've had 106 adoptions here from the Shanghai Healing Home. Most of those are through the American side. So a lot of American families have adopted from our home. And up until 2018, we didn't have any Chinese families adopt from the Shanghai Healing Home. And then starting in 2018 until now, we've already had six of them. Right now, our main goal is to try to get more Chinese families to adopt from our home. And so we've been talking with some Chinese churches here, really just trying to get the Chinese Christians more involved in this. Because remember, the culture tells them that adoption is not the norm. But we want them to think of this as a picture of the gospel and that adoption is a good thing. To adopt a child is really to show unconditional love and knowing that when I adopt this child, I am going to I'm making that child a full member of my family and I'm going to love that child unconditionally. You know, anything that we do should not be out of a motive other than wanting to serve Christ. And so when we are devoted to giving of ourselves sacrificially, I mean, that's what Christ did, right? The goal of volunteering and supporting and living out the gospel is so that it will bring glory to Christ. And for Christians who are involved in orphan care, that should be their main goal.
Orphan care can't be an American thing. It can't be a European thing only. It needs to be a Chinese thing. In this generation, in this moment right now, what does it look like for the Chinese to do orphan care? My name is David Pat. I am the founder of Renewal Missions, and we are here in Shanghai. I think one of the things that we've seen over the years is that anytime it's just one country or one group of people doing orphan care, it's insufficient. The work is not going to be sustainable. It's not going to be complete. And so one of the things that we want to do on this trip is we have to ask the question, how can the Chinese get involved in orphan care? I think we can be a catalyst, and that's one of my goals for our team, is we want to be a catalyst for the Chinese in orphan care. But we can't be the only ones. You know, one of the things that I'm trying to learn is I know what I'm good at, and I know what my team is good at, and us Americans and Europeans are good at, but have we seen the best of the Chinese yet? Have we seen the best of the Vietnamese and the Koreans and the different Asian countries who come to Shanghai and China to do missions?
My name is Aaron. 我出生在上海，也是成长在上海。我是上海。我在这个教会有12年。我们这个教会刚刚开始的时候是查经班，我刚刚开始的时候是part-time的，然后我做的是翻译（translator）。然后呢，一边做翻译呢，一边带着Bible study查经。然后呢，经过大概5年左右，我们慢慢的就是。 有几个小的查经班啊，每个查经班大概是七八个人，五个人到八个人这样啊。然后，因为我自己觉得时间到了，那么我们就把几个查经班合并在一起啊，然后我们成立了一个教会啊。 我们教会现在差不多100个人左右。 Orphanage的影响力是在这个社会上是比较小的， 因为他们是比较marginalized， 所以就是他们，而且他们这些人更多的是你需要去给予他们， 而他们很少人，他们是当然会有， 但是比较少， 就是他们能够 有feedback， 就是回馈社会的， 这样的会比较少。 而且当然这些人最终还是要回归到社会去， 回归到社会去以后， 他们其实还是要进入教会的。 其实我觉得真正福音的工作的核心还是在教会。
Have we seen their best yet? Have we seen what is possible yet? I'm not sure. And I think if I talk to my Asian friends, I don't think they fully explored what it means to do missions in an Asian way. I don't think they fully explored what does it mean to reach the unserved, the unreached, the underrepresented in an Asian way. And I think that's one of the things we want to find out. Something I'm committed to, and a lot of my friends are committed to, let's walk along this road together. In the same way that it took Americans and Europeans and all these years of a lot of mistakes, right? If you look at missions history, there have been a lot of mistakes. But after all these years of mistakes, we were also given the freedom to explore and to wonder and to dream and to say, how do we do missions in this generation?
There are some churches, not only churches, they call volunteers. 他们可能是有教会里面的，也有可能是一些他们是good heart people，他们会做这些事情。他们叫这个volunteers。当然，我觉得教会主要的工作还是应该放在就是传福音上面。但是呢，如果我们做善事也是上帝要我们去做的，所以呢，如果弟兄姊妹要去做的话，我们也是鼓励他们去做的，支持他们去做。但是就是要用他们的另外的业余的时间去做。
So we have lots of different people from different countries all around the world who come into the Shanghai Healing Home. And we haven't seen how different races or different nationalities have really played much of a factor here. Really, when those people come in and see our amazing, beautiful kids, they just are drawn to wanting to help children in need. We like to get a lot of people in here to the home, not just to see them on Facebook or on social media, because a lot of that empathy is learned. Someone who decides, I'm gonna go volunteer somewhere. They didn't necessarily just do that because they felt like, oh, I just have to go help these people. A lot of times, the very beginning, at the very first time, they were forced into it, whether that by a school activity or a church activity or their parents. But after they went that first time, they saw the need. And then after they see the need, then they were willing to continue that.
My name is Shan Shan. 然后我来自圣地亚哥州立大学，现在身份是一名学生。这次是我第一次来到上海的孤儿院。当我们真正的到了孤儿院的时候，发现跟我想象中的很不一样。我想象中的它应该是一个很大的一个地方，然后孩子们在里面有很多人去照顾他们，但后来发现三个孩子只有一个护工在照顾他们。这是之后可能。 就作为我们基督徒，可能还要更加努力的一些地方。但是相比较于别的孤儿院，其实已经好太多了。我觉得我的想法还太理想化，但现实真的很残酷。我觉得这是中国现在的大环境的影响，而且中国对一些残疾人，包括是残疾儿童上学的一些上学，然后包括对待他们和正常人。
其实还是有很大的差别的，所以我希望就是说，我们在我们这一代能够去做更多的努力，然后去帮助这一些身体上有缺陷的孩子。在中国，收养孩子是很困难的一件事情，而且要花很多的钱。我们中国政府，我觉得是他们把这个事情当成是一个 business。 所以你们也懂，然后在中国的传统观念的话，一般都不会去收养孩子，都是自己生孩子。中国你收养一个孩子，你要负责他的学习，但是要花很多钱的。那在美国，可能有些家庭他 多一个孩子可能他不会，虽然可能 也会有经济压力，但是他可以承受。那我们中国的老百姓可能就一个不太能够承受。另外一个还有观念的问题啊，中国人真是没有这样的一个观念，就是中国人的观念里面，就是自己的孩子和别人的孩子还是分得开的。
我叫许明波，这是我的中文名字，然后我的英文名字叫毕尔许。这是我第一次来到上海，然后第一次去孤儿院的话，我看的话感觉这个孤儿院挺不错的，然后那里的人啊，就是能很用心的去照顾这些孤儿，我觉得非常棒。第一次的感受就是我感受到那些孤儿的话，其实他们很需要被爱。就是像我进去的时候见到有几个孤儿，他们虽然说他们生理或者说有点脑子不正常，但是他们一过来就要你抱啊那些的，就是他们会很需要爱。在里面也发现了一些很有趣的事情，就是大部分中国人他很愿意就是捐款捐赠去帮助这些孤儿，但是呢更多的呢那些孤儿呢他会被美国的一些家庭去收养，更多的话是要让中国的人能够真正认识到一个生命的一个重要性吧。而且在中国的话，其实很多时候有很多残疾人，但是呢是被中国的一些政府被就隐藏起来了，然后把一些残疾人，其实本来很多残疾人会去就是需要去帮助，但是呢因为有一些人贩子的原因，然后呢把一些正常的或者人弄成了残疾人，然后去乞讨的，然后让那些中国人呢，其实有些人贩子欺骗了一些人，所以导致人的一些善心就会被欺骗，其实在中国会有一些这样的现象。对，所以的话更多的是让他们就是去宣传，让他们认识到生命的意义，让他们真正的从心里面感受到这些残疾人就是这些儿童孤儿是需要去帮助的。我自己的话，我是因为自己没有办法用那种爱去真正的去帮他们，需要上帝的爱来浇灌我，让我明白上帝的爱才能真正的去爱他们。
What does it look like for the Chinese to do orphan care?And if the Chinese do orphan care well, if they serve those with special needs well, what does that look like for the rest of their ministries? Because the Chinese want to go to Kyrgyzstan and Kazakhstan and all the different African countries. And the thing that I don't think, and I guess I'm going to say this because I'm part Chinese, right? I think the thing we don't do well yet is empathy, is patience and kindness and a long suffering.And I think that's what we do, that's what happens to us when we do orphan care, is we get those things. You know, we get these amazing qualities in ourselves, we serve amazing people.
So my wife and I have adopted one little boy, and then on Christmas Eve, a few days ago, we found out that we were matched to our second little boy from the Shanghai Healing Home. One of the reasons why we decided to go with adoption is thatGod has really placed us here to be able to care for this many children, and we've learned thatthese children are not any different than our own biological kids. They would be the same. We still love them the same. We would still treat them the same. And so we decided a long time ago thatif God wasn't to give us kids, then we would be so happy just to adopt children. And so the Lord has placed us here in the Shanghai Healing Home. He's brought us into this.To where, and he's opened up the door to this many children here without families. And so it's really just his way of telling us, listen, this is the right path for you guys to be able to adopt and to be able to show God's love to these children.
When I went to this 孤儿院之后第一次见到那些孩子的时候其实我不知道我该做些什么东西但是就是有一个叫轩轩的一个孩子他突然间就冲过来然后拉着我的手然后就进到那个屋子里面我发现我一刚开始的紧张一刚开始的无助都消失了我就觉得哦，他好可爱哦然后我就很想跟他一起玩然后他就一直牵着我的手虽然我不能明白他想要的是什么他就一直在向我比划的一些什么东西我后来才知道他不能讲话然后 只有一个助听器，然后我通过那些护工知道这个孩子他叫轩轩，然后包括知道了他的一些事情，然后我就觉得当下我是觉得有点难过，因为像他这样子的孩子在孤儿院里面太多太多了，而我们能够做到的只是就是陪他们，给他们更多的爱。然后后来我发现就是他真的很缺爱，然后他对领域性真的很强，就当后来 Jeremy 他们进来了以后，然后他就觉得姐姐是他的，然后他就一直把我抓得紧紧的，他不让别人来靠近我。然后当下那一下我真的就感觉心里面很 shock， 我就觉得我很少就是能够，因为在教会里面其实我也经常会做一些 BBC 的一些工作，就是那些孩子他们会有很多人去爱他们，所以他们不会有这么大的需要对一个人。然后但是这个孩子我能够感觉到他很需要我，然后那个感觉我真的无法用言语去形容他，但是我会觉得这个孩子真的很可爱，所以我就希望如果说能够有更多像我们这样子的志愿者去爱他们，如果说是仅仅是陪他们一天，虽然时间好像很短，可能有时候就只有几个小时，但是我觉得这是我们能够尽可能给他们的，虽然说对他们来说可能有的时候会有一些离别的难过，但是我觉得就像戴维说的一样，有总比没有的好。所以说我希望就是说大家能够更多的去爱他们，去帮助他们，帮助这些孩子能够活在一个平安快乐的环境里面，然后以后也能够更好的融入到社会里面进去。
There's something about serving those with special needs that's integral. It's integral to the cause of missions. When you look at the missionaries throughout history, the ones who we celebrate and we see that have done really well, why is there always a component of serving the poor? Why is there always a component of serving the outcast in missions? Because I think that's the heart of missions. I think when we lose the heart of serving those who are underrepresented, right, those who are overlooked,And when we focus only on the wealthy and powerful, or the educated, or the business people in missions, I think we lose something of ourselves. I wonder what it looks like for the Chinese to do orphan care.